here at Trucksville United Methodist Church. It is a joy to have such beautiful weather, and we welcome your presence not only here in the sanctuary, but also online today. So we have a few announcements, so I just ask you to bear with me, but what's good is that means that our church is busy and active, and there's lots of opportunities for everyone to get together. So first and foremost, the Cedar Crest Cemetery Association meeting is Tuesday, June 28th at 7 p.m. And that will be in the conference room at the church. UM Army, please keep that date. It's July 10th to the 16th. What an incredible opportunity for our community to get together with the youth and the adults and to do an outreach to our community for projects that for people that are in need. In addition, the chicken barbecue is one day this month, July 15th rather. It's Friday only. You can get tickets, well, you could have gotten tickets before service, so, or after service, or please reach out to the church office and Aaron will gladly put your tickets on reserve. We also have Leaf Through the Summer, which is a neat opportunity for us to share with Reverend Leonard Hoxton as far as he has been in ministry for a really long time. And so we are blessed to have his presence on July 16th, I believe it is. It'll be right following worship, our Saturday evening worship. So I encourage you to join him. He will reflect, he's written several books, and he will reflect on his years of worship with his congregation. So it should be a very worthwhile time together. Also, we have Vacation Bible School, which is July 24th to the 28th. I know Kristen Eckenrode and Jennifer Reinheimer, they're looking for volunteers. So please do, you know, reach out to them if you can help. And also sign up your children. So I think that ends the announcements at this time. And Pastor Jay has an additional one.
Good morning.
Good morning.
It's good to be with you. The announcement that I want to share is actually this past week the Staff Parish Relations Committee met and interviewed some candidates for the Congregational Care Coordinator. And I'm happy to share with you that we offered the position and she accepted to Jill Kristen. And Jill will begin officially on July 1st. We'll be sharing some more information about that position itself and just kind of how we see that operating. It's a new position, and so there will be some ways that we'll need to work through some issues. But certainly I welcome Jill and I look forward to working with her as one of our staff members. So.
If you want to just go for a walk, which is what people did yesterday afterwards, it's a wonderful place to just walk and see all of God's creation. If you want to go fishing, if you want to come out and kayak. I have to tell you, yesterday was an inspirational day with members of our congregation, but I also encourage you, bring friends. This is the perfect opportunity. It's much harder to go through those doors for people that are not used to we all feel welcome with the bird singing and everything. So please, I just encourage you. Yep, July 2nd is our next time together. And, you know, we just look forward to everybody joining us. We had a lovely group yesterday. They ranged in age from 3 to something at the other end. And so it is a time together for all of us, okay? And those that are online, this is a perfect opportunity outside to spend time in God's Word, in God's creation. So, without any further announcements, I just ask you to settle your hearts, your minds, your bodies, and your soul. Wayne's going to ring the bell. Dr. Steve is going to bless us with a prelude, and just immerse yourself in worship. Today in all kinds of emotions.
Some of us. us have had our share of challenges.
Some of us have experienced the gift of life in a second chance, a new baby.
Some of us have experienced the sting of death through the loss of a loved one.
We gather no matter what our emotions and look to God.
We look to God for assurance, for strength, for peace. Meet us where we are, O God. Speak to us in this time of worship.
And now I ask you to remain standing if you're able and join us for our opening hymn, O God, our help in ages past.
Children's moment today, I wanted to share just something that I really enjoy doing in some of my spare time, and that is, if you go to the first slide, crossword puzzles. to, of course, to subscribe to a newspaper and had one of the favorite newspapers where I would rip out the crossword until I got a chance to get to it. Had a stack of newspapers about that high. And I would do those again in my spare time. Don't always have that spare time to do that. You also might make note I have my Jet Pace pen there. Most everybody here, I think, has probably a Jet Pace pen then too. I guarantee use a pen, but sometimes I have to scribble out what I wrote in then too. Now, I have to share with you, I love my puzzles, especially my word puzzles, but I have to share with you, if we go to the next slide, I have to have the answers.
That's what you need to say.
I have to have the answers. As a matter of fact, so one of the puzzles that I showed a picture of in the previous slide, the clue was going to the back of a boat or something like that. And it was 2, 3, 4, 5 letters. And it's abaft, A-B-A-F-T. I've never heard of that. So I did have to cheat last night and look at the answer then just so I could finish that particular puzzle. But again, I just can't seem to do puzzles unless I have the answers. So that stack of newspapers that I used to have, it would frustrate me when I didn't, for whatever reason, rip out the crossword puzzle from the next day or something like that. The next day's answers were in there. So, and I thought about this because of some of the things that we're talking about today. We all have lots of questions in life. And we like to have answers to all of those questions, too. And sometimes it's real frustrating when we don't have those answers to questions. And a lot of that has to do with our relationship with God, our relationship with each other, trying to understand some of the things that happen in our lives or to others in our lives. Lots of really hard questions. And we're going to talk about that in just a little bit more, too, as we share in one of my impactful scripture passages, Psalm 77. Because in that psalm, we're going to hear a lot of very powerful questions. And I think, to me, one of the things that we have to realize is we may never have some of those answers while we live here on earth. We pray to God that maybe when we meet Jesus and we have a sit down with Jesus in heaven, we're able to ask some of those questions and maybe Jesus will fill in all of those blanks and provide for us some of those answers. But for now, sometimes what we have to do is be comfortable with the questions that we do have. That's what I thought about when I thought about the crossword puzzles and my need for the answers. Let's take a moment to go to pray. Lord God, we thank you on this day that we can come to you with our questions. And Lord, at times you may help provide answers to those questions. But at times, we need to trust that some of those answers may not come until we experience glory in heaven with you. And so help us, Lord, to find comfort even in our questions. These things, Lord, we ask in your name.
Problems in school and how, like, I hated them. every day is like a word problem sometimes. And we don't always know the answer, but aren't we blessed with the people God surrounds us with each and every day? Because sometimes they are the answer, just to provide us with that comfort and peace. So, as we enter a time of prayer, the list looks long, but we do have many joys. And first and foremost, and I kind of chuckle because I looked at this, and Jay, there's one that's missing here, and that's this weekend, correct, is when you started here in our church 4 years ago. And I have to say, these last 4 years, as turbulent as they've been, you've been like a rock for all of us, and we are blessed by your, you know, guidance, your leadership, and your love of God. So we thank you for that, and we look forward to the future. And much on the same kind of note, our dear friend Bill Bachman, he starts his time of leadership in the Princeton and Old Forge congregation starting next weekend. They are blessed. I mean, Bill was here last week in worship, and his message was powerful, and he's just an inspirational individual. I could listen to him all day long. Mm-hmm. That voice is amazing. So, what a blessing to those congregations. And, you know, I encourage you, send a note to Bill, or just, you know, reach out to him, and let him know that we support this mission and ministry.
I just wanted to add, I shared it on a prayer request that George Barrett actually served 2 weeks, the last 2 weekends, or maybe it's this weekend and the weekend before, at one of the local congregations too. So we have a number of our folks that are serving even beyond the local church, which I'm really happy about as well.
Also, we have a joy. We had a wedding yesterday. What a spectacular day. Pastor Jay officiated. It was Gary Turner and Jennifer Bryan. This is Dale and Jenny's daughter, and they were married yesterday at Phil and Tanya's lake house. And what a beautiful setting in Shikshini. So we wish them well, and years of happiness and joy, and I hope that the day they celebrated as a family continues and goes forward in your life. And again, just a reminder, we had the praise in the park. I love that. I didn't name it. I think, is it, you know, Mark, my buddy Mark, God bless him. If you didn't see it yet, it's nothing like hitting your, you know, a bug for a club, but Mark wrote a beautiful piece yesterday that he sent out in an email, and he called it Praise in the Park. I certainly love that much more than the R's that I, you know, coined together. So that's what we're going to change it to, Praise in the Park at Francis Slope. So again, you know, please join us next weekend at 9 o'clock, because it'll be another spectacular day in God's creation. And in addition, Pastor Jay sent out, took the time to send out the addresses of the people who have been baptized recently, who were confirmed, or who graduated. I encourage you, take a name a day or a couple of names a day, send them a card, pick up the phone, do something to encourage them, because they are starting new times in their lives of, you know, their journey in Christian faith. So those words of encouragement are what keep that connection to God, so real for them. And in these trying times, how spectacular is that to know that they have a congregation that loves them and wants to be with them and to work with them during this time. I think that is it for the joys, but I know that all of you have joys as well. And now, as far as things that are weighing on our hearts. please, if, you know, think about that as you go forth in this week. Also, for those who have experienced loss,
our family and friends of Gene Harrison,
Melody, Mel Landy, the Justin Moss family, Christopher Venusi, Rob McCullough's family,
and also Brian Michael,
Daryl Crick. For thinking of you, Janet, with the loss of your cousin Daryl.
We're thinking of you.
I know you had a long illness, but still, it's a difficult time
for your family.
We keep all of our shut-ins and some family members. Again, Aaron does a fabulous job in keeping those current. Please, you know what? Think of that during the week, because your days can be long and they can feel lost. So please keep that in your prayers.
Also, our retired clergyman spouses, Reverend
Candler, with you and Judy through your journey, Chuck and Vi Gomer, and all the clergy and congregations that are going through this time of transformation.
Next week is that time where pastors are changing
their churches. It's a very difficult time. This church of all churches is also familiar with that. So please think of them in your prayers for this time of transition. Those in our church normally who need our prayers.
Frank Wagner, Jack Delore,
Jeanette Gollum, Madeline Root, and Anne Mae Pop.
These individuals have had some real challenges in the past several weeks, in the past months, and some of the past years.
Keep them and their families in your thoughts and prayers, and reach out to them and see if there's something that you need to do for them. And those of our extended church family,
Jane Akachi and her
husband Ben, that's a relatively new one. Jill, these are people
that Jill knows from Colorado.
Ben,
and if I get this wrong, Jill, please correct me, but was diagnosed with ALS
and now also has contracted COVID. Please keep this family in your prayers. Jeff Finici, God bless the Cardell family and the Coffin family. This has been such a long road for Jeff. And although his smile is usually ever present, he's part of his face.
For Randy Mark
and his family,
Gina Polina,
for Sam
and Dale Jones,
George, Nancy Gagnette, for Erica Texera, she's in Tech Act teacher, Danielle McNulty, the verdict, which is Reiner's
Paul Kim's brother, Kim. For Betty Lowry, and Bill and Susan
Jones. Please keep those in your prayers. And also,
for all those who are spoken and private prayer requests. Gracious and loving God, that list sometimes is a little bit overwhelming for us. But through those hard questions that we sometimes just bash you with, let us feel comfort in your presence with us
today. Because through it all, you keep your promises.
You are the same today, tomorrow, as you were in the ages past. And through this incredible time of transition in our lives,
isn't it nice to know that you are always there? So those that feel lost or confused or just have those unanswered questions which just keep burdening their hearts, let them find peace, whether it's in your creation, whether it's with that neighbor that sends a special card to you just at the time, or whether it's with a phone call or your own way, you do provide answers to those problems, whether they be ones that we have to wait patiently to see how it ends. So Lord, although our list is long, we fail it, and we just ask and are comforted by your word that you provided to Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, the perfect prayer that guides us and that we can use each and every day when we are at a loss for the word that we need. Our Father,
Thomas or Matt, would you be willing to help with the buffers?
We get confused in a certain world. We use this as a small portion to encourage those in their ministry and your word to us.
scripture reading comes from Psalm 77, verses 1 through 13, the New Revised Standard Version, updated edition. I cry aloud to God, that he may hear me. In the day of my trouble, I seek the Lord. In the night of my hand is stretched out without weary. My soul refuses to be comforted. I think of God and I moan. I meditate and my spirit faints. You keep my eyelids from closing. I am so troubled that I cannot speak. I consider the days of old and remember the years of long ago. I commune with my heart in the night. I meditate and search my spirit. Will the Lord spurn forever and never again be favorable? Has his steadfast love ceased forever? Are his promises at the end of time? Has God forgotten to be gracious? Has he, in anger, shut up his compassion? And I say, is it my grief that the right hand of the Most High has changed? I will call to mind the deeds of the Lord. I will remember your wonders of old. I will meditate on all your work and muse on your mighty deeds. Your way, O God, is holy. What God is so great as our God? The word of God for people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you, Barry. Thank you, Spirit Singers. I do appreciate that very much. Will you pause with me for a moment of prayer? Let the words of my mouth and the meditations of each of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Two plus years of COVID, the war in the Ukraine, all kinds of political divide within our nation, the death of loved ones so dear, the rising cost of inflation and all of the pressures that it puts on the local family. A possible split in the denomination that we love. Racial conflicts. Challenges at work, at home. The ending of long-time relationships. The list could go on and on. I don't know about you, but I'm tired. I get tired fighting, struggling, reaching, trying to understand, deciding what is my best response, even keeping my chin up. It's easy to find ourselves in a bad place. And truth be told, we don't help ourselves at all. And what I mean by that is perhaps we avail ourselves too much to all of the partisan news channels, which tends to fuel some of our reactions. Or we never disconnect. Our cell phones and other devices allow us to remain connected 24/7, and we never seem to find that peace of mind. Or we run ourselves ragged with the schedules we keep. Our calendars control us. Or we don't properly care for our physical, emotional, for spiritual needs. And as a result, our time with God suffers and our inner strength gives out. And we find ourselves in a bad state. Hurting. Suffering. Vulnerable. Even feeling alone. And we do the only thing that we feel we can do. We cry out to God. Help us, Lord. Help us. Sound familiar? It's all too familiar, not only because it describes much of our lives and some of the struggles we all have today, but because it also describes some of what is going on in today's psalm that Barry read. For it's obvious as we hear that psalm that the psalmist, whom we believe to be David, that the psalmist is in a bad state. Now, there's no way of knowing for sure what has transpired, but what we do know is that the psalmist is in trouble and reaches out to God for some help. But I find what the psalmist finds most concerning is that when he reaches out to God for some help, help does not come in the psalmist's timetable, nor in the manner in which the psalmist had hoped. And so this leads the psalmist to ask what I would call some very deep theological, even existential questions about God and God's apparent absence. Listen to these questions again. And imagine, if you will, again, if we believe that David wrote this psalm, King David, one of the patriarchs of our faith, verbalizing these questions to God. Will the Lord spurn forever and never again be favorable? Has God's steadfast love ceased forever? Are God's promises at an end for all time? Or has God forgotten to be gracious? Or has God, in God's anger, shut up his compassion? Do you hear the depth, even the pain, in these questions? Again, reality is that these are some of the most fundamental questions that perhaps we all come to at some point in time in our lives. Questions about God. Questions about God's love. Questions about where God is when we need God the most. Questions about why all of these challenges have come our way. And I say to you, it's okay. Ask God questions. It's okay to challenge God in the tone and tenor of these questions. Do you hear some of the sharp tone to the questions that David asks God here? It's okay to be totally transparent with God in the asking of these questions, to bare yourselves, your souls, your emotions. And as I indicate in the title of today's message, there are never too many questions that we ask God. And some of the great men and women of faith had these same doubts and fears and questions. Here today, David, and I would add that this certainly isn't the only time that David shares in this sentiment. Just as an example, another time in Psalm 143, David says, "Hear my prayer, O Lord, for the enemy has pursued me, crushing my life to the ground, making me sit in darkness like those long dead. Therefore my spirit faints within me, my heart within me is appalled, my spirit fails. Do not hide your face from me." Powerful words from David, one of the patriarchs of our faith. But David's not the only example in Scripture. Moses had his struggles with God. Elijah and Jeremiah, the prophets, had their struggles. Job, the righteous man, remember we did a series on Job. Ruth, who eventually became the grandmother of David, had so many tragedies to experience. Mary, the mother of Jesus, called at a very young age. Peter, as we shared in our long-term series of Peter, and even Paul. All of them had doubts, fears, and questions. And so dare I say, it's biblical for us to have doubts, fears, and questions too. But all of those men and women of faith had one other thing in common. They ultimately came to trust God. We see this in today's psalm, too. In the midst of doubts and fears and questions, the psalmist says these words, "I will call to mind the deeds of the Lord. I will remember your wonders of old. I will meditate on all your work and muse on your mighty deeds. Your way, O God, is holy." And then I love this rhetorical question at the end. What God is so great as our God? In other words, it's almost as if the psalmist says, I may still have doubts and fears. I may still have many questions that I may not have answers to. But God, I will trust in you. Your way, not my way, your way, O God, is holy. Maybe today we are tired, fighting, struggling, reaching, trying to understand, deciding what is our best response, even keeping our chin up. Maybe today we find ourselves in a bad place. we can take some direction from all those men and women of faith. Look to God. Lean on God. Remain close to God. Own up to your feelings and emotions with God. Share all of these things to God. And don't be hesitant to ask the powerful, necessary, and existential questions that you may have. Ultimately, trust God. Trust God's way. And know that you know that we are not alone in our struggles. But God is with us. Praise be to God. Let us pray. Lord God, we thank you. We thank you, Lord, for this powerful passage of Scripture, which helps us today. Helps us today to understand that even some of the greatest men and women of our faith had fears, doubts, and even powerful questions. And yet, ultimately, these men and women of faith, even in the midst of their struggles, trusted you. Lord, help us to follow that example and to trust in you. These things, Lord, we ask in your name. Amen. Our closing hymn for today is number 534, Be Still My Soul. And I want you to pay attention in particular to the first verse of that hymn. If you would just go to the first verse, please. 534, let me get it here by the hymn. Listen to this verse. Be still my soul. My inner being. The Lord is on your side. Bear patiently the cross of grief and pain. Leave to your God to order and provide. In every change, God faithful will remain. Be still my soul. Your best, your heavenly friend through thorny ways leads us to a joyful end. Again, we may not understand it in the midst, but God is present, and God will provide. I invite you to stand if you are able and join me in singing, Be Still My Soul.
Be still my soul, God, my God.
months, and then maybe